to something good. I know that you are always up to something good. You'll make a way, whatever it takes. There's nothing your love won't endure. I know that you are always up to something good.
God is greater than my feelings. He knows everything. are greater than all I feel. You know it all and you always will. I trust in you with all that I've got. Doesn't even matter if I feel it or not. Woo! You are greater than all I feel. You know it all and you always will. I trust in you with all that I've got. Doesn't even matter if I feel it or not.
Woo! God is greater than my feelings.
He knows everything.
God is greater than my feelings.
He knows everything.
Boys and girls, welcome to week 6 of Concrete and Cranes. When you're building, you need the right tools. Just like a drill for when you're trying to put in screws, and like the power drill is pretty cool, you need the right tool to do the job. I have my tool bag right here, and in my tool bag, I can find the tools to live life God's way. Now, I have my level. Is that gonna help me? Can I find my way to live God's way? Oh, no, okay. And I have my tape measure. Is that gonna help me? No, Miss Brooke is losing it today. I have my Bible. We use God's word is how we learn to live life God's way. So take out your Bible. Here we go with our sword drill. I'm gonna say this passage of scripture and you're gonna find it. Ready? Philippians 1:6, go. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus.
Have you ever really needed your friend? And if you've ever been let down by your friend, you've probably been pretty upset with them. In our Bible story today, we learned about how Jesus, right before his time came to be crucified, went to pray in the Garden of Gethsemane. Even though Jesus is fully God, he's also fully man. So he was scared, just like you or I would be. And I don't know about you, but when I'm scared, I want my friends praying with me to help me feel better. Well, Jesus asked his friends and disciples, Peter, James, and John, to stay awake and pray with him. Jesus cried out in the garden and asked his Father if there was any other way to rescue his people. Can you imagine how scared Jesus must have been? The Bible says he was crying so hard that blood began to run down his face. And when he went to his friends, he found them all sleeping. All Jesus asked was that they stay awake and pray with him, and they couldn't do it. I would be so angry, but Jesus, he just returned to praying and then went on to die for us. And not just those of us who love him, but also for his friends who fell asleep and totally left him hanging. He died for the people who threw stones at him and the people who spit on him. He died for everyone. Boys and girls, Jesus loves us so much that he went to the cross to die for us, even though he was scared. He chose to die for us, knowing that we were going to let him down, just like his friends who kept falling asleep. When we choose to believe in him and follow him, we get to be part of God's amazing plan. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you for going to the cross and dying for us, even though you were scared. God, I pray that you would just work in every boy and girl's life who's watching this service. And Lord, if there are any here that they haven't made you their forever friend, they haven't taken that step to say that they believe in you and they want to follow you. God, I pray that right now in their heart, you would just speak to them and that they would say this prayer. Lord Jesus, I believe that you are who you say you are. That you are God's son, that you came to earth, that you died for our sins, and that you came back to life, and that you're in heaven waiting for us. I give you my life, Jesus. Help me to live life your way. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great Sunday, boys and girls.
Hi kids, welcome to day 3 of Concrete and Cranes, and this is your activity for today. Have you ever been on a real construction site? I have. You need lots of stuff. You need this hard hat. You need a vest. You know what you also need? A name tag. Because they just don't let anybody walk around a construction site. You can get run over by a bulldozer. That wouldn't be good, would it? So today, get some paper and a marker and draw yourself an ID card. I did mine. Even draw a picture. That's a good likeness, isn't it? If you don't have a lanyard, just get a piece of string, mom will help you poke a hole, and you can wear this lanyard so when you're on the construction site, they know who you are. Guess what though? Does Jesus need you to have a name tag? No, he doesn't. He knows everybody's name, and he knows yours. Because Jesus knows you're so important to him. You're worth so much to him. So much that he died on the cross, rose from the dead, just for you and just for me. So it's good to have your name tag. Draw a happy face. Draw something fun. Draw your favorite activity that you like to do. Something that will recognize you with your name. Just so you know, when you build your life, Jesus built the foundation of worth because you're worth so much to him. Hey, enjoy this activity and have a great day.